Thus is the club that I am going to give away. Yo, what's good everybody, it's your boy Nickel the Barber, and today we are back with yet another video. So basically today I have really good news. I'm sure you guys saw in the title, I did make a promise and tell you guys that once the channel reaches 300 subscribers, I will be doing a Clipper giveaway. And guys, guess what, earlier this week the channel finally hit 300 subscribers. So I'm sure you guys are wondering what's happening with all these Clippers in front of me. I am actually about to record a review on these Safeway Clippers right here, and this is the Clipper that I am going to give away. I hope that you guys actually watch the review on this Clipper. I'm giving it away for a really good reason. Like I said, I appreciate all the love and support you guys continuously show me. So me giving this Clipper away is just a way of me showing you guys that I really appreciate and I am thankful for all of the love and support. Just so that you guys know, it is official. Let me show you guys. Let me bring out the proof, you know. Yes, sir. I'm sure you can see right there, 305 to be exact. But like I said, I really appreciate you guys, and if it wasn't for you guys, I wouldn't have been at 300 subscribers. So like I was saying, I'm about to record the review on the Safeway Clippers. I will be giving away a set of these Safeway Clippers right here. So how to enter the giveaway is super simple. I will be posting up a I will be posting up a picture on my Instagram. You can go ahead and check me out on Instagram. It's at @Enrico_thebarber. I will be putting it up somewhere on the screen. Not 100% sure as yet, but it should be popping up on the screen somewhere over here. So what I will be doing is I will be posting a picture up on my Instagram. What you need to do is you need to be subscribed to the YouTube channel. You need to be following me on Instagram. And what you need to do is you need to tag 3 people you think should win the Clipper, or who you think deserves the Clipper. So like I said, you need to be subscribed to my YouTube channel. You need to be following me on Instagram. And you need to tag 3 people in the comment section on who you think should win the Clipper. Who you think, even if you want to tag yourself, it's more than welcome to do so. And then what will happen is on Monday the 12th of April, I just need to double check that date for you guys, but Monday the 12th of April I will be going live on my Instagram account, on my Instagram live. I will be going live around 6 p.m. and I will be doing a live draw. That way I want to make sure that the giveaways is as fair as possible, because I want to give each and everyone an equal opportunity. And like I said guys, I really appreciate each and every one of you guys. Thank you for the 300 subscribers. Let's keep growing this channel together. So I'm sure you saw in the title, today we are doing the mud skin fade with the crop top effect. So like I said, I appreciate you guys. If you are new to the channel, definitely go ahead and smash the subscribe button. Definitely hit that notification bell, because we are dropping content regularly. I'm trying to be as consistent as possible, so definitely smash the notification bell so that you are notified every time I do drop a video. And just let me know how you feel about the content in the comment section. Interact with me in the comment section. And yeah, for the last time, I really appreciate you guys. And yeah, I will be posting a picture up really soon. So don't forget to enter the giveaway for these Safeway Clippers. I will be dropping the review on the Clipper really soon, so you can definitely just fall back to the review, you know, get my point of view on the Clipper and my thoughts. I really think it's a super good Clipper, and for a beginner barber, I think it would be an amazing start, starter kit. And yeah, let's just go ahead, let's check out today's tutorial. Like I said, we are doing the mud skin fade with the crop top effect. I really appreciate you guys. Guys, so let's go ahead and jump straight into today's tutorial. As you can see, we are doing the mud skin fade, and I have put together the full step-by-step tutorial for you guys. So first things first, we're gonna go ahead and start off by
combing our clients hair out. As you know, it's always good to start off on a nice and clear, nice and brushed out canvas. So next off, we're gonna start by taking our wall designers. As you can see, I have my wall designer flipped around, and all I'm doing right now is I'm basically setting in my first initial guideline. So I'm currently setting in my first zero guideline. And with this guideline, I'm just basically giving my client a little bit of a drop in the back. I'm sure you guys are constantly hearing me say that I like to make my haircuts stand out. I like my haircuts to be super different. So yeah, I just gave him a little bit of a drop in the back. It really does make a difference in your fades. You'll notice it if you do, like, you know, experiment and just try to make the haircut as unique and find ways to make it stand out, you know, so that people know that, yeah, that's your work. So next off, I'm gonna go ahead with no guard lever open, and what we're gonna do is we're gonna set in a next guideline of about half an inch. And when I do set in this guideline, I try not to create a harsh guide. I try not to create harsh guidelines. So as you can see, I'm using a flick motion. That way it is much easier for me to blend this guideline out. So with this step, it is good to go over the same spot a few times just to make sure that you do get the head and even a nice and even length. So now what we're gonna go and do is we're gonna start working that line out. So as you can see, I'm basically gonna just adjust my lever all the way until I'm back to my lever being closed. So I'll adjust it just a little bit, and as you can see, I'm working on that same line for just a bit, and once I feel comfortable at that length, I just go ahead and I adjust my lever until I'm back to my lever being closed entirely. And then I'll just follow that exact same steps at the back as well as on the other side. And like with my client, you'll notice that in this video I take a bit longer than usual. So my client has a little bit of a difficult hair texture. That's why getting rid of a few guidelines did show me a little bit of a challenge, but you guys know every day is a challenge, so it just depends on how you fight through it. So yeah, it did take me a little bit extra time, but I managed to get rid of the line. And next off, I'm going ahead and I'm setting in my next guideline. As you can see, I have my number one guard on, lever open, and I'm setting in yet another guideline of about half an inch. I'm gonna make sure that this line is even and consistent right around our client's entire head. And like I said, my client has a little bit of a thicker grain, so you'll notice me really going in and, you know, debulking, trying to get the hair as even as possible. Next off, once I'm happy with the length that I'm at, I'll go ahead and close my lever. I still have my number one card on, and I'm still gonna continuously use a flick motion. And now we're just gonna basically work on that line. As you can see, it's already starting to lighten up, and you'll notice at the back, I left the bulk. We're gonna come back with the scissor over comb method. And yeah, so as you can see right now, I'm basically just trying to lighten up that guideline over there. And once I am happy with the length, I will come through with my 0.5 cut. So now that I'm happy with the length, I have my 0.5 guard on, starting off with my lever open, and I'm gonna work my way to my lever being closed once again. Once I'm comfortable with the length that it's at, I'll definitely go ahead and close my lever. And as you can see over there, just went ahead and I closed my lever, and automatically you'll notice that that line is starting to disappear and our haircut is immediately starting to come together. So all that we're gonna do right now is we're gonna follow that exact same steps. We're gonna apply to the back as well as the other side of the haircut. Next off, I'm basically just gonna go in and do some detailing work. So I'm starting off with no guard lever open, and I'm basically just gonna work my way through it. If I feel like I need to adjust my lever, I'll go ahead and adjust my lever. But for the most part right now, all I'm going ahead and doing is I'm doing a whole lot of detailing work, making sure that I get the bottom part of the fade as clean as possible, so that when you start working on the transition into the top, that it really comes together really smoothly. So next off, I have my 1.5 guard on with my lever open, and you'll notice me angling my clipper. And what I'm basically doing is I'm not digging in, I'm basically continuously using a scoop motion, and with this I'm basically giving the haircut shape. And once I am comfortable with the length that I'm at, I'll go ahead and close the lever, and I'll apply the exact same steps to the back as well as the other side. So as you can notice over there, I'm not taking too much of hair off, I'm basically just giving the bulk area over there some shape. So now for the next part, jumping back to my number one guard, and we're gonna focus on that dark spot, that dark line over there. Starting off with our lever open, and then once we are comfortable with the length and we can notice, or once we notice that there's not any more hair coming off, we can go ahead and close our lever, continuously use a flick motion, use those corners of your blades if need be to get to dark spots, just to lighten up any dark spots. I'm sure you guys have seen, I'm sure you guys have noticed by now that this is a super long tutorial, but like I said, my client has a little bit of a difficult hair texture to cut. I'm sure any other barber can relate, and that any barber that can see that or that does have any clients with this type of hair texture, it's not the easiest to fade because of the darkness and the thickness of the grain. Next off, we're gonna go ahead to my 0.5 guard, starting off with my lever open and then working our way all the way to our lever being closed again. And you guys will notice that in this tutorial, I really come back, I jump down to my lower guards quite a few times, because like I said, it's a bit of a difficult texture. So when you are as a barber, you need to do whatever about whatever you need to do. So even if you're going to take an extra 10 to 15 minutes with your client in the chair, you need to do whatever possible, or whatever in your power, to make sure that you give your client the best end result possible. So if it means you need to be running 15 minutes late into your next appointment, then I guess it's something you need to do, because like I said, customer satisfaction is always a very important thing, especially in our line of business. So you, like I said, you literally need to, if you need to take the extra 15 minutes, you need to just take the extra 15 minutes, and then, you know, you can always just make up for time later on, or don't take a lunch break, etc, etc. So next up, we're gonna go ahead and do some scissor over comb work. So as you can see, I'm showing you guys how to basically use your comb so you don't scoop straight in. As you can see, as I put my comb in, I angle it, and then basically my scissor and my comb run smoothly together. So as you can see, I'm basically angling the comb off of my client's head, and all I do is I take my thinning shears and basically we run through the back as well as the sides. Guys, let me know in the comment section how you feel about this cut. If you think the cut's looking super crispy, let me know in the comments. Like I said, this was a super difficult texture, and I feel like I did pretty well with the haircut. So I want you guys to let me know what you think about the cut. So next off, I'm gonna go ahead and grab my number two guard, and now we're basically just gonna blend. We're gonna blend in that bulk area over there, to make sure that our haircut has a nice and smooth transition. As you can see, there is a few dark spots over there, and that's why we're coming through with the number two guard, just to work it out nicely. And like I said, you guys will see, notice me jumping down to lower guards a number of times, and that's just me basically just trying to get the best end result possible. Like I said, my client's hair texture was a bit difficult to cut, so I found myself constantly jumping in between guards, trying to knock out all these dark spots that you guys are seeing. Next off, I'm just applying some holding spray to my client's lineup. This helps to hold the hair in place, and it really gives you a nice and crispy lineup. So next off, I have my wild detailers in hand, and basically all we're gonna go ahead and do is we're gonna get rid of the bulk amount of hair at the bottom of that we left behind. So basically, if you are a regular viewer, you guys know that I prefer using the detailers when I am balding my client out, because they really give a close cut. And for people that have sensitive skin, like, it doesn't bite, or, you know, it doesn't hurt or irritate the skin. So I really prefer using the detailer when doing this process. So now that we're done balding our client out, what we can go ahead and do is we're gonna focus on the lineup. So as you guys know, I always start my lineups in the center, and I either move to the left or the right. So as you can see, today I started in the center, moved immediately to the left, and yeah, I'm not gonna speak too much on this section. I'm just gonna basically allow this lineup to bring the entire haircut to life. So all I'm gonna do right now is I'm gonna sit back and I'm gonna allow this allow the lineup to bring the entire Ika to life. So now what I went ahead and did is I just sprayed some, applied some water to my client's forehead, and now we're gonna go in and do our razor work. So it all depends on you. Some guys prefer doing dry shaves. I just prefer applying water because for me personally, I feel like it's uncomfortable and I wouldn't want my client to feel uncomfortable. So I just find it more, well, I find it better to use to apply water. Some guys use some shaving gel. I guess it just depends on you, like your preference. And right over here, I'm just applying some styling powder to my client's hair. I'm gonna take my styling comb, just get a nice, you know, a nice messy look going at the top there. And guys, this was Riyadh as when he walked into the shop before we got the haircut in. And this was Riyadh as soon as we're done with the haircut. Guys, I hope you enjoyed today's tutorial. Don't forget about our clipper giveaway. If you are new to the channel, definitely hit the subscribe button. Don't forget to smash that notification bell. And most importantly, interact with me. Let me know how you feel about the content in the comment section. Until the next video, peace.